Hello everyone, this is SWTOR here, back with another Star Wars Republic video. Today I have for you guys another Star Wars Republic, a little discussion type video where I'm just going to be talking about something that I kind of have, you know, wanted to talk about since the launch of Knights of the Eternal Throne. I haven't mentioned this, you know, here and there before on the channel, but I'm just going to make a pretty, not really a long video, but it's going to be, you know, sort of something just talking about a bunch of different things relating to the game. That's going to be what does this game need to survive. Now, this game isn't like on its last leg where it's like, oh hey, you know, this game is going to die. It's not like that at all. But, at you know, the current way they are doing group content, all that different stuff, I feel like if they just kind of keep this up with the way they're doing, I feel like there's going to be a, you know, even a bigger, or, you know, an even bigger decline in subscriptions and stuff with this game. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoy this video. As always, if you guys enjoy these videos, then make sure to leave a like. And if you guys want some gaming mints, then check the link in the description down below, Catalyst Gaming Mint. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoy this video, and I'll see you guys in this discussion. Alrighty guys, let's get into this right now. So once again, I mean, this is going to be kind of a video where I talk about some of the stuff that I've kind of noticed when it comes down to the game, or rather some of the stuff that I've seen that could help it succeed, and I just really want to kind of talk about this just in general, because I feel like this is something that is pretty important when it comes down to the game itself, since a lot of people want a lot of stuff to change with this game in general. They just want to see a bunch of good stuff happen with it. And at this, you know, current rate, like I said, I feel like, you know, if they want to be really successful and succeed, then they are going to need to change up a few things. So the first thing I'm going to be talking about is the lack of group content. Now, this is basically kind of a meme at this point that BioWare, you know, creates almost no group content for this game, and the group content that they create is essentially just recycled garbage. But I mean, to be fair, that, like I said, I mean, it's kind of a meme at this point that they do that, but I feel like they could do a turnaround. I feel like they could definitely kind of like change what's happening and change everything that's going on with the game. It's not like, oh hey, you know, BioWare, they're just completely done with this game. Not at all. Because one thing I did definitely notice with this game, in, you know, more or less with the recent live streams, is they're trying to increase communication in this game in general. I mean, I've seen that because they've just increased the amount of live streams, they just increased the amount of support to other YouTubers and live streamers, all that different stuff. So it seems like they are trying, in a sense, they are definitely trying to, you know, do some stuff. They're trying to kind of go to the community to try to show that, you know, hey guys, we're here, we're just changing some stuff up. So, I mean, that's a good sign, but at the same time, you know, there are some other issues. Like I said, just kind of the whole entire idea of not releasing group content. If they really want this game to succeed, or rather they, you know, what they need to do to keep this game running even longer than it might actually run, they definitely need to just, I say, increase the quality when it comes down to group content. They need to really start releasing more of that, because, you know, otherwise, there are some people like myself that continue to play the game and will likely, you know, continue to play the game. But at the same time, it is getting to the point where when you release no group content for an MMO, you're going to have a bunch of other players that are, you know, likely going to leave. Because, like I said, I mean, if you're playing an MMO, then there's a good chance that you obviously want to play group content. You want to do, you know, raids, PvP, and all that different stuff. Now, it's fine if you want to play the story, but at the same time, once again, I don't go into a multiplayer game expecting just to play the story. That's a bit ridiculous, but I mean, for now, we do have, you know, quite a bit of group content. I mean, this game in general has a lot of group content with it. It's just that as of recently, they haven't been releasing any group content, which is the main issue that a lot of people have. Now, the next thing I think this game really needs, more importantly, or probably the most, I think the biggest aspect this game needs right now, is the devs need to be more honest with us. I feel like they kind of dodge a lot of questions, and they just kind of like give really vague answers to essentially everything you ask them, which, I mean, that's really annoying. It's not like trying to say, oh, you know, the devs are not doing their job, they aren't working. I mean, obviously they are trying to work with the game, you know, change a bunch of different stuff up. I'm not trying to like attack them or anything, but I feel like one thing that I've noticed, you know, very specifically with this game, is that they give really vague answers, and I really don't like how they actually kind of give vague answers, because, I mean, some people would say, oh, hey, look, they're giving us, you know, more feedback, they're talking to us, clearly they do care, which, I mean, obviously, yeah, they do care about the game, and they definitely want to see it succeed and grow, But at the same time, you know, one big issue they really have is they give answers. They might say, you know, oh, hey, group content is coming in this next live stream. And then you ask them what it is, and they say, we can't tell you. And then you go to the next live stream, and then they talk about it again. And then they say they can't tell you again, and it's just rinse and repeat, just never-ending cycle. They did mention, you know, in January, they're going to talk more about group content. But at the same time, this whole entire idea of just kind of, like, avoiding questions and kind of not really answering stuff directly is a bit annoying, and I really kind of hope that they do stop that. Because if they do eventually, you know, start giving direct answers, I feel like more people will kind of stay with the game. Because if they're, like, really direct and they're honest, they're like, alright, look, we're going to be creating this type of content, we're not going to be creating this, so people get a good understanding. I feel like they might, they won't actually do that, is because they're afraid that people are going to leave the game if they hear it, you know, what they want isn't going to show up. But it would be a lot better if they were, you know, kind of being honest and then just leaving people in the, you kind of like the dust, because some people just unsub. They just stay unsubbed because they hear that, you know, they get really vague answers about what's happening. But if, you know, BioWare were more honest with it, I feel like it would help out a lot with this game. Now, another thing I feel like this game seriously needs is kind of a revamp on rewards, or rather just something to give more incentives for playing the actual game. A good example of, you know, not really having really good rewards in this game is with the last ranked PvP season. If you saw, we really got almost nothing. We got, you know, a few titles, which are cool. I mean, it's always cool when you do get titles in the game. But at the same time, people really wanted some weapons and armor sets, and of course they didn't deliver. They gave us, you know, a pretty, they actually gave us a reskin of a mount. Of course, they've done that in the past. Of course, you know, released stuff on the cartel market. But they gave us a reskin and all that different stuff. So some people were angry. So that's one thing that I feel like they should kind of focus on rather than, you know, just kind of the cartel market. Because one thing I seriously noticed, you know, recently with this game is if you look in the cartel market and you go into the collections, if you check, you know, when Knights of the Fallen Empire was coming out and you just check the amount of shipments, just click on this right here. This is the most recent shipments. But if you go here, you can see with the Alliance packs, this is when Knights of the Fallen Empire was out. You have, like, so many cartel packs, but if you go to the last ones, you know, there's not as many. I mean, there are some, but at the same time, you just check, there's just, like, tons of Alliance packs just when it was actually, you know, kind of starting up. So, I mean, that's just something that I feel like is important just to go ahead and note, is that it feels like, you know, they are kind of focusing a bit more on the cartel market rather than the in-game rewards. Because one thing that I've noticed, and a lot of people also kind of agree with, is when you're playing a game, if you do give more rewards and incentives to players just to go ahead and just complete content, you say, like, oh, hey, you know, if you do this well in ranked, you're going to get some really cool armor sets and stuff just to show off, then people are, you know, more likely to do it. It's really annoying when you go into a game and people are, you know, more focused on the cartel packs than actually getting stuff in the game. Because I notice that that sometimes happens, as you see in general chat, you know, people don't even really care about the stuff that you can actually earn in-game. They care more about the cartel pack items, which, I mean, that's fine. You can get cool stuff from cartel pack items. I'm not saying, you know, they shouldn't have that. But that one thing that kind of seriously irritates me is they give more, you know, I would say they give more detail and they care, or they at least, you know, they give the idea that they care more about the whole entire idea of cartel packs rather than stuff in-game. So that's one thing that kind of does annoy me a little. It's something that they've kind of done for the most part since they did release the cartel market. Which, I mean, hey, to be fair, they do need to make the money somehow. So, I mean, I can't really just say, no, I'm too against that. They just want to make, you know, money. And people are willing to buy the cartel pack, so they can definitely keep that. But I feel like they should focus more or less on, you know, some aspects when it comes down to earning stuff in-game rather than just purely the whole entire idea of the, you know, cartel market itself. So that's something right there. Now, of course, you know, we do have some other stuff just to note with the game. And one of the biggest things that I do want to say is the fact that this game got ridiculously easy. Now, I know some people may say, you know, it's just kind of the mentality that if you play a game longer and longer, the game gets easier the more you play. Which, I mean, to be fair, that makes 100%, you know, sense. You know, the more you play a game, the better you get and the easier it does actually get. But I feel like gameplay-wise, I don't know what it is. It just feels like a lot easier than it was before. It could just be, you know, just kind of seeing things. I know that some people say that they feel like the game is easier. But I don't know what they did. I mean, first off, I mean, with Knights of the Fallen Empire, they did dumb down operations a lot. They didn't really dumb down the harder difficulties. But that was kind of disappointing that they actually decided to dumb down some of that stuff. And, yeah, I mean, that was something that was a little disappointing. They also kind of dumbed down a lot of the whole entire idea of choice when it comes down to classes. When they did the whole entire, you know, discipline system, I feel like they really dumbed down the whole entire idea of the game. They made it really simple to get abilities and stuff, which, I mean, that's fine. But I liked before when they had the skill tree system where you could kind of, like, customize and design the class the way you wanted to. I feel like they kind of limited the amount of options that you could really have with this game by doing that, sadly. As much as, you know, I want to say, you know, the discipline system is really nice, which, I mean, it's true, it is nice just to be pretty simple and just allow people just to get right into the game. I feel like, you know, the game has gotten a bit more simplistic, which that could be for the better or the worse. It just honestly depends on what the player feels. But with me, I feel like it isn't really the best. It could be, you know, it's kind of like a middle ground. It's not something that's very serious to me. But I feel like, you know, they did kind of, you know, dumb down a lot of stuff, or rather, you know, made it a lot easier than it already was. Now, I know what some of you might be saying right now is, you know, Snoopy, why are you being so harsh about all this stuff? You know, normally in your videos, you try to kind of look at both sides of the stories and the opinions and views when it comes down to just, you know, dev choices and game choices. But I mean, with this, I just really want to kind of talk about the stuff I personally feel like. You know, this is kind of like my opinion. I mean, if you want to, or you have a different opinion, then you can just go ahead and, you know, state in the comments down below. I'm, you know, open to all opinions and views. But, you know, personally with me, these are just some of the things that I feel like the game really needs to succeed. I just wanted to make that little disclaimer right there. Is that, you know, once again, I'm not trying to, like, bash the devs or anything. I'm just trying to bash the game in general. Because, I mean, obviously, I'm playing it right now. I do enjoy the game. But these are, you know, a very select few things that I feel like need to be fixed. Or they need to be improved in some way if they want to go ahead and just, you know, keep subscribers up. Rather than just have them kind of, like, fall apart and just fall down. So, I mean, that's something right there. Now, there are some stuff that I really do like with the game that they are kind of, like, turning around. I mean, to be fair, the whole entire idea of Uprisings, as much as it's like a recycled content, it is enjoyable. You know, if you're like me, a player that sometimes isn't able to get on at certain times, and I'm just really busy, and of course, you know, I want to complete something really fast, then an Uprising is nice because I can finish in like, you know, 10 to 15 minutes. So, I mean, with that player style, or, you know, rather with my play style, when sometimes I'm busy, I'm not able to play, that's really nice because I'm able to just like jump into something and get it done rather than go into an operation like this and take a you know, a little longer of a time just trying to kill bosses and complete it. So that is something that I do like about the game. But if they one thing, you know, I would suggest is if they tried to balance out you know, different types of group content along with these uprisings, that would help, you know, a lot more. I feel like just purely focusing on, you know, uprisings won't work out too well. I know that some people like them. Like I said, I mean, I myself do like them for, you know, just the value of what they are. But at the same time, there are players that don't really have that play style and they just want to play, you know, kind of like a binge the whole entire game. You know, for a certain day, you know, they just want to play all day just some good old Star Zero Republic. But, you know, there are some people that just want to play only Star Zero Republic one day. You know, they're like, all right, you know, I'm just going to have a Star Zero Republic marathon. They're just going to play all the game. I feel like that content really isn't going to help out that player. So that's something I feel like they should really do just to help improve. Is they should kind of focus on finding a middle ground when it comes down to that stuff, of course. Now, I could honestly go on and on and on about some stuff I feel like they should change or fix it with this game. But one thing I feel like they should really focus on, you know, personally in my opinion, is they should definitely kind of focus on the whole entire idea of, you know, kind of doing some stuff with the game. Or, you know, specifically, more or less, one thing I feel like they should really focus on is they should definitely focus on kind of a bigger deal when it comes down to just, you know, some of the events that the community tries to do with the games. I feel like, you know, that's definitely something that should be noted and should kind of be a big priority with the game, because I mean, recently with the live streams, they've just been trying to, you know, kind of talk about influencers and just, you know, or, you know, influencers just trying to go ahead and just, you know, promote their content, which is, that is definitely, you know, really nice that they actually do that. But at the same time, one thing that could help a lot with, you know, just kind of keeping players here is, you know, someone could be scheduling an open world PvP event on a server and they could kind of like promote that, just mention it. So, you know, if players want to get together and do that, then that'd be really nice. I know recently on Reddit, we actually had you know, not really a Reddit post, but, you know, someone actually set up, FOTM set up a open world PvP event on Tatooine on the server, which was, you know, absolutely really fun. Just, you know, rushing in, just trying to take down some people. That was always really fun. I really do like open world PvP. So I feel like if they somehow were able to, you know, promote it, something like that on their stream, that would definitely help out a lot. It is nice that they are trying to, you know, kind of talk to creators and just trying to help them out with stuff in this game. I've personally, you know, tried to contact Eric Musco. I've never actually gotten a response from him for anything. So, you know, that's kind of like a ripperoni and pepperoni. But I mean, still at the you know, the same time, it is good that they are at least, you know, trying to contact and talk to, you know, at least some creators in a sense that, you know, they're just trying to go ahead and just help them out with making content with the game and all that different stuff. Now, one more thing I do want to say is that they should, you know, try and fix the class balance issues. I know that this is really hard when you make a game, you know, you have to balance all the classes together and whatnot. But I feel like they should have, you know, some devs just, you know, purely focus on the class balance issues. Because, I mean, we have issues with, of course, you know, the commandos and the mercs just being, you know, slightly overtuned when it comes down to it. We also have issues, you know, where people just feel like, you know, their class isn't really performing the best when it comes down to PvP and or PvP just when it comes down to numbers itself. So that's one thing they should definitely kind of look into because there are some complaints about it. So that's something I've noticed. I haven't, you know, been worried too much about class balance because, I mean, at this point, almost every class has, you know, so many defensives that they can be essentially a tank. But I do feel like, you know, definitely commandos do need a little tuning. They definitely need to be fixed in some way, shape, or form. So we do have that, of course. But other than that, I do apologize that this video is, you know, really long. I just kind of wanted to have a somewhat long video, just kind of like a real talk with you guys. You know, what I feel like this game really needs to actually succeed. Now, I understand, you know, if some people don't really like my comments or say, you know, I'm being too harsh about the game, 100% justified, I can understand that. But if you do have, you know, something you want to just talk about and say about the game in the comments, you can definitely leave it and, you know, just leave it in the comment section. And I will, of course, read them since I do like seeing, you know, what other people think about this game and all that different stuff. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this Social Republic video. As always, if you guys enjoy these videos, then make sure to leave a like and subscribe. And I'll see you guys in the next one.